Hello everyone and welcome to my channel. If this is your first time here or you are seeing this video or this face for the first time, welcome to my channel. I'm Temi and on my channel here I film videos around food, weight loss tips, keto diet, low carb meals and so much more, and also market runs sometimes. So today we have a special video about the keto diet. So if you want to know what we have in stock for today, please make sure you keep on watching. Alright guys, like I mentioned earlier, if it's your first time here, please do me a favor by hitting the subscribe button down below. Give this video a thumbs up. Also hit the notification bell so you do not miss any of my uploads. And today we're going to be talking about the reasons why you are not seeing results in your keto journey, your keto diet, especially if you are in Nigeria and you've been trying to lose weight via the keto diet or the keto program. So I've been on a keto diet for a long time. I stumbled upon keto diet in year 2019. That was what I did to lose like drastic weight till, you know, where I'm right now in my maintenance stage. So after that, in 2020, I've been doing the keto diet on and off. I'm just trying to give you guys a background for you guys to know that I've done so many experiments on or concerning the keto diet for you to know that I know what I'm talking about. All right, I may not be a professor or a doctor, but I have experience. I've done, you know, some extensive research on keto diet to know what is going on and whether you are doing it right or not. So if you are doing the keto diet and you're noticing that you are not, you know, losing weight, you're not dropping any size down, the first reason will be that your macronutrients are being calculated wrongly, or you are not even calculating your macronutrients. What are your macronutrients? They are the, you know, components that make up your whole food. You have the fat and oil, carbs, protein, and that's just it. So in the keto diet, you know, they are the three primary macronutrients which we always mention are carbs, fat, and protein. Those are the three things you should have on a keto diet. So if you're not calculating your macronutrients properly, probably your ratio of fat is not calculated well, which is supposed to be 70%. Your carbs, which should be 5 to 15, some people 20% of carbs, and your protein should be a moderate amount of 20%. So probably you're having more carbs and, you know, more protein than fat, whereas your fat should be like your main intake. It is a diet where you substitute carbs, like you take them out of your system completely and you substitute it with fat. So it is a high fat diet. You need to make sure you are taking enough fat, not enough carbs. So you cannot be having the normal amount of carbs you used to have before and the amount of that kind of, you know, whole fat and be expecting to lose weight. It's not going to happen. You are going to either keep putting on weight because you're eating carbs and a lot of fat, or you're going to remain the same. So you're probably not calculating your macronutrients properly. So you need to make sure you start calculating your macronutrients properly. There are some apps you can download that can help you to calculate your macronutrients. You can check, I think it's Lose It. I don't even know the name of the one I'm using at the moment. So you can check the app called, I think it's Lose It. Yes, it's Lose It. That you can just input what you're having for that day. It can help you if you want to, you know, calculate a long time or a long stretch. If you are, if you have a goal that you are working towards, you can use that to calculate your goal moving forward. Just input your food, your breakfast, your lunch. It will calculate your macronutrients, it will calculate your calories for you, and you're good to go. So you're probably not calculating your macronutrients properly. Once you start doing that, you are going to be sure to see results. Also, another reason would be that you're not drinking enough water. So you need to drink enough water. I cannot emphasize this enough. Like, even if you're not on a keto diet, you need to drink enough water. when you take water, you are going to aid your body with digestion. You're going to aid your body. Everything is just going on easy. There's no need for stress. And also with the keto constipation, you know, you are missing a lot of fiber in your system. Like the fiber you used to get from carbs, you are missing it. So you get constipated. So water is going to help you with that. I'm not going to go into keto constipation that much today. We're not talking about keto constipation. We're talking about the reasons why you are not losing weight on a keto diet. So you need to take enough water because it will aid digestion, and when your body, you know, digests food quicker and properly, you'll be sure to start seeing the sizes or the size drop. Also, you should be doing some kind of exercise, even if it's to lift your leg once in a day. Please take a walk, okay? Go outside, take a walk. I'm not saying you should do rigorous exercises, but you still need to do exercise. Don't just depend on keto diet. I know I mentioned I didn't do any form of exercise when I was on keto diet because I didn't even like exercising then. But at least I took walks. I used to walk then because back then I was still in school and I used to walk from my hostel to class, to and fro. Like I can go 5 times without complaining because I always go, you know, when it's time for class I have to go back, and it was a distance. I used to walk from there to the shopping mall. I walked very well, and then after some time I started skipping. So you need to do some form of exercise. Yes, you have to actually exercise. Also, it may be that you are not fasting. So if you are new to the keto diet, a good way the keto diet, especially if you just started it and like for the first 2 weeks you lost drastic weight and you're wondering, why am I not losing weight yet? You need to start fasting. You need to start doing the intermittent fasting, and that is going to like help you, like, you know, slash your weight and take it off completely. How I am right now with my maintenance, it is intermittent fasting that has helped me sustain this size that I am. So it's not like I eat carelessly. I eat what I want, but in moderation, in reasonable amounts. I don't just, you know, binge on food that I know are not healthy for me, food that I know I don't need in my system. Also, I don't joke with my intermittent fasting. Once it's 6 p.m., I stop eating, sometimes 7 p.m., and I count like the 16th or 17th hour till my next meal. That is when I have my food. So do not joke with your intermittent fasting. Make sure you fast. Also, if you are new to the intermittent fasting, probably you do not know what the intermittent fasting is. I will leave a card up here. Please make sure you do check out this video. It is very important. If you have no idea what I'm talking about and you're just hearing the word intermittent fasting for the first time, I have detailed videos, but this one I'm going to link up here is going to be the most detailed of them all. It's like teaching intermittent fasting to a kindergarten. Moving on, the next point will be that you're not getting enough sleep. You are not eating enough food. You need to eat enough food because if you don't eat enough food, your body is just, you know, excuse me. If you do not eat enough food, your body will not just go and start taking fat. Instead, it is going to store that one for you because it is afraid that what if you pass out? Your body cannot just start tapping into stored fat. You need to eat enough fat for your body to know that, oh, now we're using fat to, you know, give her energy or give him energy. So you need to eat and make sure you eat enough fat for your body to readjust. So if you don't eat enough, if you're starving yourself, you're doing the wrong thing. When you starve yourself, when you do not eat enough, your body is going to store fat very well, okay? Because it is like, we're going to use this fat another day. When do we know the next time food is going to come in to us? Something like that. So your body is going to actually store that fat and you will not lose weight. So you need to eat properly, eat enough of fat for you to see results. Also with sleep, you need to sleep properly so that your body can work. See, your body is an engine. You need to, you know, rest. When you rest, your engine will work properly. All right, my last point will be the most important point because people used to wonder, why will I want to lose weight and then I'll be eating cheese, I will be, you know, putting butter in my tea, I will be eating all these fatty foods and using oil to fry my egg and fry my food. They are wondering, you need fat. You need to have enough fat. Keto diet is a diet that is fat based, and you need 70% fat in your meal. Like, it's a diet where the macronutrient contains 70%, if possible 80%, because all that is what is going to give you energy. And if you are not eating fat, if you are not consuming fat, you will not be able to lose weight, because your body is just going to store the one in your body, whereas it is waiting for, you know, new fat to use to give you energy. So make sure you take enough fat, take enough water, have, you know, moderate amount of sleep. 6 to 8 hours ahead is fine. Me, I sleep for like 12 hours. I sleep for like 12, 14 hours. We are the jobless, or we are the lazy Nigerian youth. Just kidding. So I heard 6 to 8 hours is fine. Whichever one it is, just make sure you get enough amount of sleep. Please don't sleep for 4 hours. What's going on? Did you kill somebody? So make sure you get enough sleep. And with all this I have mentioned, I hope you get on with your keto diet. You are progressing with your keto diet. People are always in my DM saying, hey, why are you not on keto diet again? I wish you were on a keto diet so that you can help us with our journey. I still have the knowledge. It's still in my brain. So if you have any questions about the keto diet, please, you can send me a message. You can write them in the comment section down below. I'll be sure to answer them. Any concerns containing, you know, keto diet, whatever it is, you can send me a message, send me a mail. So we have come to the end of this video, guys. If you haven't subscribed up to this point and you are sitting down there listening to everything I was saying, you know, taking notes, and you did not still subscribe, please, Bikonu, help me and subscribe to my YouTube channel. It is absolutely free. Nobody is going to charge you for it. Please subscribe to my YouTube channel. Give this video a thumbs up. It is very important. You know, let people in the YouTube office know that I'm using their platform properly. And then, yeah, that should be it. You can check out my other videos, which will appear on your screen, either here or here. And I will see you in the next one you are about to click on. Bye.